يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, in Surah Al-A'raf, as we heard in the previous episode, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses us all by calling us Ya Bani Adam, O children of Adam. And we went through the first instruction where Allah told us to dress appropriately. He has sent for us clothing in order for us to cover, not in order for us to reveal. And He wants us to dress with the clothing of piety, both in terms of what we cover ourselves with, as well as our general character, conduct, and the way we carry ourselves. Today, I'd like to look at another instruction, a few more, where Allah says, Ya Bani Adama. So in verse number 26 of Surah Al-A'raf, Allah addresses us for the first time. Then in 27, again, He says, يا بني آدم لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة ينزع عنهما لباسهما ليريهما سوآتهما. الله أكبر. Allah says, O children of Adam, don't ever let shaitan test you or abuse you or overcome you in any way. Make sure that you don't let shaitan trap you with his traps, because he has removed your forefathers from Jannah. He took your forefathers out of paradise, meaning he took Adam and Eve, Adam and Hawa, may peace be upon them. Allah says, shaitan trapped them. Be careful. Go and read about that. Go and find out what shaitan did. Shaitan promised them two things. Shaitan said, if you disobey Allah, you're going to live forever and you will own everything. Both of those were just a lie. But shaitan put it forth so beautifully, and Allah says, they regretted it. They sought forgiveness. And then look what happened. They were removed from Jannah. So Allah says, shaitan's aim is to make you reveal your private parts, to make you take off your clothing. Subhanallah. You take off your clothing, that's from shaitan. Allah says, watch out. Shaitan wants you to be immoral. Shaitan wants you to actually forget Allah. So he warns us and says, be careful, don't fall into the same trap of the devil. Otherwise, you will be exposed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not expose us. So sometimes people sin, they've engaged in immorality, they might have committed adultery, they might have had a past, and they've sought the forgiveness from it, so it is wiped out, it's gone. Don't doubt the forgiveness of Allah, but you need to know one thing. Let your heart achieve comfort that if Allah did not expose you while you were sinning, He will not expose you when you have repented or while you're repenting. So be comforted in that regard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about this. And Allah tells us, you seek the forgiveness of Allah. Allah will cover you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't expose your private sins when He knows that you have sought the forgiveness of Allah. Sometimes Allah exposes us when He loves us, because He wants us to put a stop to what we're doing. You have people who sometimes they're exposed to their own spouses, to their own children, to their family members, to their parents. That sometimes is a sign of the love of Allah. If Allah didn't love you, He would have left you to continue committing the sin. But He loved you so much that He showed your wife what you were doing, or He showed your husband what you were doing, not because He hates you, because He ultimately loves you and He wants you to quit the bad. So, my beloved spouses, give your spouse a chance. If you've caught them doing something bad, study the matter. If it is not such a serious matter, consider the fact that that may have just been the love of Allah exposing it to you in order for that to stop. Because if the sin didn't stop, it would have been the anger of Allah, or perhaps Allah didn't really love that person. But because of the love of Allah, they were exposed. So don't look at exposure as though it is the end of the world. It could be the beginning of the beautiful life in the obedience of Allah after someone was sinning for years on end. Isn't that comforting? Subhanallah. Look at the comfort in this time of crisis when someone is caught, literally caught, doing the wrong thing by a person who's close to them. The first thing shaitan makes us think about is, I need to end this marriage. Why? Look at what my spouse was doing. But Allah wants you to consider, hey, hang on, this man was doing wrong. We loved him, so we showed you what he was doing just so he could stop it. And now he stopped it. Will you not consider that perhaps it was just our love that made that happen? It requires a heart of gold to look at it that way. Subhanallah. May Allah grant that to us. The same applies to any other sins. When Allah's exposed you and you've quit it, that was the love of Allah. That was Allah wanting you to come. So this is why Allah says, watch out. It's a trap of the devil. But don't allow yourself to plunge further into it. Come out of it. Allah says, we won't expose you. The devil wants to expose you. But sometimes, if we have, while you were repenting or something of that nature, perhaps it was because we wanted this whole thing to stop. May Allah grant us ease. Let's move on. Allah says, Ya Bani Adam, khudhu zinatakum 'inda kulli masjid. You know, it's amazing. This is verse number 31 of Surah Al-A'raf. Before I actually translate it, let me explain something. The context of these verses, Allah speaking about the dress and the lessons from the story of Adam and Eve and Shaitan, how we should be dressing modestly. Shaitan wants us to expose and Allah wants us to cover. So Allah says, we've sent adornment. People adorn themselves to show other people. Sometimes it's the right people, your spouse, your family members, and you're doing it for yourself sometimes. But sometimes it's the wrong people. You're trying to impress those who couldn't even be bothered. You're trying to impress those whom, by impressing them, you're going to plunge yourself into crisis because you might end up doing the wrong thing altogether. Allah saying, you really want to impress someone with your clothing? Well, impress Allah. Whenever you go to pray, wear the best clothing, apply perhaps a little bit of perfume if you're going to the masjid, and maybe look into wearing something that would be so presentable. Allah says, now I'm translating this verse, verse number 31, O children of Adam, take your adornment, wear adorning clothes. You know, wear beautiful clothing, lovely, modest, beautiful clothing, in the kulli masjid, at every place of prostration, which includes the houses of Allah. When you're going to the masjid, wear some good clothes. You're going to meet Allah. When you're about to stand on your musalla or sajjada or mat, prayer mat, wear some good clothing. You're standing in front of Allah. Wear some good clothing. Look presentable at least. Take a moment to check what you're looking like. It might be your last prayer and you're standing in front of the Lord of the worlds. Allah says, O children of Adam, when you come to pray, wear some good clothing. Wear some good clothing and eat and drink and don't be wasteful. Allah tells you, don't be wasteful. Sometimes we're so wasteful just because we have and we forget that Allah is testing us. You might have, that doesn't mean you should be wasteful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, indeed, He does not like those who are wasteful. My brothers and sisters, Allah tells us in verse number 35 of the same surah, Suratul A'raf, that whosoever is conscious of Allah, makes amends, they will have no fear at all and they will never have reason to be sad. If you're conscious of Allah, you make amends, you improve yourself, you become a better person, you're constantly looking at becoming a better version of yourself every day and you have a good relation with Allah, He says you will have no reason to fear and no reason to ever be sad. He will comfort you. And this is why Allah says, those who believe and do good deeds, we will indeed grant them paradise. We take a look at verse number 43 of Surah Al-A'raf. Allah says, the people of paradise will be the believers who did good deeds and those who sought forgiveness. Paradise was created for those who seek forgiveness. Subhanallah. Have you sought forgiveness? Well, it's about time we ask Allah to grant us forgiveness. Let's change our ways and habits. My brothers, my sisters, Allah says, when the people will be seated in paradise, we will remove from within their hearts any hatred or jealousy or envy, no negative qualities whatsoever in the hearts of those who will be in paradise. So in this world, there is a little bit of jealousy, there's some hatred, some of us, we have worked on those habits and some haven't. Allah says, when you get to paradise, you won't be jealous of one another. There won't be any ill feeling at all. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلْ We will remove from their bosoms that which was negative, the ghil, you know, the negative feelings towards others, the envy, the jealousy, and so on. Allah says, removed. And the people of paradise, do you know what they will say?
وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَا لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ
They will say, Alhamdulillah, all praise is indeed due to Allah who guided us to this. And we would have never been rightly guided had Allah not guided us. Subhanallah. Verse number 43, Surah Al-A'raf. We are echoing what we said in the first of these episodes of comfort in times of crisis, that guidance is the biggest gift Allah can give you. I've said this a few times through these series, and I am here today ending this episode by telling you that yes, indeed, the people of paradise will say, we praise Allah, Alhamdulillah, the same beginning of Surah Al-Fatiha. Alladhi hadana, the one who guided us. Throughout our lives, we continued asking Allah, O Allah, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. We started off praising Allah and then we said, guide us to the straight path. Today, we are saying all praise is due to Allah. So we are starting in the same way. And we are saying we are thankful and grateful to Allah who guided us. Which means ultimately your dua was accepted. You were guided. And we say on that day in paradise, may Allah make us from them who say, we thank Allah, we praise Allah for having guided us to this. And had He not guided us, we would have never been rightly guided, Alhamdulillah. And this is the beautiful way that we will all have ended our lives on earth and entered into paradise. May Allah grant us all paradise. Ameen. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين